Good morning everyone. This is class 12th computer science chapter 5 file handling lecture number 4. In the previous class we people know that what are reading functions and what are write functions. So with the help of the read and the write function we can write the data into the file and read the data from the file. So in this class we will first discuss the homework of the previous class, after this absolute and the relative part, then flush function. So these are the topics of today's class. So now let's go with first that a discussion of the homework. In the previous class I gave you two questions. So this is question number one, that write a program to get roll number, names and marks of the students of a class and store these details in a file called marks.txt. This is a very simple program. So here I have written the program code and I have added one more field, that is subject. So here what will you do? You have to just open your file demo 1 in the write mode. You can see the write. Then answer is 1. You will run the loop until the condition of answer is 1. Take one empty list. Now input the values from the user and append these values in the list. After all the values are inserted in the list, then in the last you will just write the content in the my file object. So here I am using this write lines, because write lines store the result in list form. Now again I have just taken the input from the user, that answer is int, input enter 1 to continue. Now I have closed my file. So these are the data that I have run and I just want to insert these data into my file. So after running this, the file store the two results. That is, first is Ankit and second is Varsha. So this is the answer of first question. Now second question, write a program to add two more student details to the file created in program 1. So in this case you have to use the append mode. So here in this you can see that here is the append mode I have written here. So by this the previous data is exactly the same as you have seen, and now two more records you want to insert here. So run this. Now these are the two records that I want to insert in demo1.txt. So after running this file, now the file shows four records. Two are from the program 1 and now 3 and 4 from the program 2. Okay. So these are the questions related to the write operations. Now in next topic is path, absolute path and the relative path. So first we need to understand that what is path. The path is a sequence of directory names which give you the hierarchy to access a particular directory or file name. Suppose any file is in your system, you want to access it, then you have to see the path. What will you do? You have to just right click on the particular file and then click on properties. So by clicking on properties, it will show a pop-up. In this, the field location says the exact path of the file. So path is just a sequence of directory name, that where the file has stored. So there are two types of path. This is first one is absolute, second is relative. Here is a hierarchy. In this, the drive is E, then project and sales are two folders, and in project there are two subfolders, that is project 1 and project 2, and in sales has cache folder. And if you want to write the path of project 2, then E/project/project2. Okay, this is an example. Now types of path, this is absolute and the relative. So what is absolute path? The absolute path are from the topmost level of the directory structure. Okay. So this is the example. Like same, this hierarchy follow a path. You want to access project 2. So you have to write the complete path of project 2. This is known as the absolute path. For example, if you want to write the path for cash, then you have to write the E, then slash sales, then slash cash. Okay. When the complete path is showing, then it is a absolute path. Now next is the relative path. Relative path is that path in which the project, in which it is showing the current working directory. Okay, here in this example, I need to access the project 2. So this one dot, it is saying that we are in this folder and we need to access only this project. So this one dot says that we are in current directory. And if we write the two dot, then we have to move to the parent directory, that is E. So the relative paths are the relative to current working directory denoted as a dot, while its parent directory is denoted with the two dots. Okay. Now next is the flush function. What is flush function? Basically, when we are writing the data and then we are writing the data, write some content, and after this we just with the help of the file handle we are closing the file. Okay. But the flush function says that whatever is in the buffer, it will directly store in the memory. It will not wait for the close function, that the file should be closed, then the data will go in the memory. Sometimes the data may be corrupted by the close function. So before the data get corrupted, flush function automatically sends the file to the direct. So the flush function forces the writing of the data on disk still pending in output buffer. Okay, whatever the data is in buffer, it will pushes or force the data just to go to the disk or in any storage device that is given in the program. So by flush function, I will just show you the example that what is flush function. I need to open the Python. Here is my file. Okay, so in this I have opened a file that is text.txt. Now in this file I need to write the output is slash n. Again I have written my work status is, then I call the fflush function. Flush function, it will directly push these write operation in the file. Okay, before waiting the close function. Now s is okay, again f dot write s, f dot write slash n. So this is again f dot write, finally over. Now I again call the flush function. So it will again call, it will again all or add all the data in the file text.txt. Okay, so whenever you are calling the flush function, it will force the data just go in the file. Okay, so now I am going to run it. It has run successfully, no error. So I will show you the output. Chapter 5, all files, and then text, this one. So the output is my work status is okay and finally over. Okay, so this is the output of this program. Now the homework is, you have to write the difference between absolute and the relative path. Okay, absolute and relative path, just go through with the absolute and the relative path and try to write the difference. Okay, so till now, thank you and have a nice day.